the TSB group.
The six judges at the London Business School's Women in Business Awards this afternoon were, naturally, eminent women, led by Eve Newbold, the company secretary of Hanson PLC. Yet, ironically, two out of three winning acceptance speeches came from men. Nevertheless, the judges were unanimous in picking Rank Xerox the overall winner.
What we liked about the Rank Xerox entry was that they had set themselves numerical goals and publicly committed to them. They intend to double the women managers in their workforce by 1995.
Back in 1987, Rank began a series of seminars, from the board of directors to the most junior workers, to discuss and implement its new equal opportunities policy. At that time, only 10% of managers were women. Now it's risen to 14%. Rank say it's not just morally correct, but also good for business.
43% of the British workforce is women, and our intent is to avail ourselves of the broadest possible array of talent in the marketplace. And as we go through the 90s, there's already a shortage of skilled labor. Well, we aren't going to limit ourselves to 50% of the available talent. We intend to attract the brightest and the best, both men and women, and we think it's a great source of competitive advantage.
But why am I talking to a man about this subject?
Well, David, it turns out I'm the managing director at this point in time. I suppose if you come back in a year or two, you could well be speaking to a woman.
Though there's no positive discrimination as such, women are encouraged to apply for traditionally male jobs like service engineer. And women say they have noticed a change in corporate culture.
Personally, I mean, I'm just about to make a move to the regions myself into a marketing manager's role. There's five regions, and I'll be the only female marketing manager out of the five. So, yes, it has, personally, for me.
It doesn't mean that people step back and say, she's female, therefore I have to pay attention to her. They do think more positively about you. They are willing to consider you, to value your judgments and your opinions on matters much more so now.
But today's awards coincided with a survey showing that girls' school leavers still go overwhelmingly into the same traditional, clerical and caring sorts of jobs. Judges called for better advice at an early stage.
Young girls are not getting, I think, adequate career advice about the diversity of opportunity that is out there today for them. And I would have to say to the career advisers, come on, get with it. There is a lot of opportunity out there for young women today.
Plaudits for the winners today, but judges said that many companies don't even pay lip service to equal opportunity. This is David Strawn for Thames News.